What's up, guys? Frank here on Barge to Hell, the world's most extreme metal cruise. Over the next week, I'm going to be taking a look at all the mayhem, live bands, parties, and everything that goes down here. But if you couldn't make it, let's take a look at some of the highlights right now. Andy, you have basically built a monster out of Ultimate Music Cruises. I mean, how does this all make you feel, knowing that, you know, here we are in the second successful run?
It makes me proud, you know. And I mean, I have to thank all my guests, first of all. They make it a success, you know. I mean, we just executed, but without all the guests and with you people from the press, all this would never be possible.
From your perspective, what is it that keeps people coming back?
It is just this unique atmosphere, and I think what sets us apart from some of our competitors is certain things that we do different, because we consider everybody the same. We don't have VIP areas, we don't have VIP check-in, we don't have VIP treatment. And this is, I think, what makes it special and what sets us apart, and probably this is also part of what makes it successful. You know, this is different. We're all metal. We're all the same.
It's the best festival I've ever been to. I've been to Inferno in Oslo. I've been to Maryland Death Fest. And, you know, those are great. You see a lot of good bands. But the whole overall experience of this, everything from the people I've met, the bands, hanging out with the bands, even the food, you know, come on, everything's been the best.
It's a little different, you know, but it's been all right. It's been good, you know. I've most important thing, seen a lot of friends that I wouldn't usually see. So it's been great.
It's been, you know, way to see a bunch of bands that I like a lot and also laugh at watching them drink pina coladas like Mayhem was doing on stage last night.
Yeah, it's been fun.
We've got no retirement plan. We're never going to have the money to come on one of these cruises when we're retired, so we might as well do it now.
Yeah,
we get paid to come here as well, so it's good.
Yeah, it's nice. Everyone get the chance to do something like this normally, so it's been fun.
Second time on the metal cruise, and this one obviously more extreme lineup, which is more down my line, so yeah, it's been rad. It's been everything I thought it'd be, so.
It turned out to be better than we expected, so. But this cruise is like a mix between playing gigs and having a vacation. It's pretty awesome.
I came across a banner that said March to Hell, a listing of all these bands, and it was within 5 weeks after our wedding day, so I just decided that's our fucking honeymoon.
Yep. She yelled it out from the other room. I'm like, shit, they do that kind of thing? Hell yeah!
It's a lot of friends and bands playing, and we are kind of stuck together on the boat, so I had a chance to watch a lot of shows. Really, that's a really cool thing, because many times we pass by each other, you know, festivals and stuff, but we can't make to the show, but here it's more chance, you know, it's easy to reach the stages and stuff, so pretty good time.
It's absolutely great. It's so nice to meet all the bands around. If you're going to for breakfast or for lunch, they're all around. If you're watching bands, they're sitting next beside you, and all the bands are very good, playing good songs and having a lot of fun with you together. That's really cool.
I think it's great that it's not too crowded.
Yeah.
You get like a good view of each band playing, and each band plays twice, so you really don't miss anybody. Like, I missed Christy on the first night, so.
Well, you're gonna see him tonight,
pretty so. Pretty fucking stoked to see him tonight, so.
It seems like here in the United States there isn't too many festivals, so this is one of the better options, I guess, if you wanna have this festival thing going, and so it's really, really cool, you know, and especially since it's on a boat and makes it even more special.
People who are here, they are really, really dedicated people and very nice. The fans, you know, and the friends, they approach in a nice way, never pushy, never stressy, you know.
Being in the sunshine in Minnesota, it's snowing, so being in the sunshine with
watching metal in a hot tub,
in a hot tub drinking with hot people from around the world.
Hell yeah.
Fucking fabulous.
So many different languages I've heard today.
Now let's check in with my buds in Municipal Waste and see what they're up to.
Oh, hi, I didn't see you there. Tony Foresta checking in from Barge to Hell. And I just wanted to take a moment to show you all the wonderful things that you can do on this ship. Barge to Hell, let's do this. Rock climbing! Chilling hard as shit in a jacuzzi.
Oh,
shuffleboard! We're playing ping pong with newfound friends.
Fine dining.
Basketball. Merchandising.
Can I get a black shirt?
Or getting your yoga on. Exercise. Belly flop competition. Or punishing people in your favorite bands.
Bro, Eye for an Eye is like my jam, dude. I've been listening to that shit since I was a kid. I mean, like,
gambling. Trying to cure a hangover. The bars are also open 24 hours a day. You can have a lot of fun if you do it right. So, thanks Metal Injection for having me, and I hope you guys all had a great time on Barge to Hell, because I did. I did as shit. It was good as shit.
I had to sleep, man. This is fucking bullshit.
All right, guys, and that brings me to the conclusion of my Barge to Hell wrap-up report. I hope you had a lot of fun watching it. I certainly had a lot of fun making it. And I hope next year, when they do this again, I get to see some of you out there.